March the Drove Call. Now we're going to have music special written for Brass Band. In fact, a contest, please. It's written by George Lloyd, a distinguished English composer, who I suppose first came into contact with the bands when he was a Marine serving in the war. But in the order of his life, he said he'd been interested in brass bands and written a number of pieces, the most recent of which is the one we're going to hear now. It's called King's Messenger, and it obviously harks back to the days when the King's Messenger travelled by horse. And he depicts various kinds of horses in the music, which is inspired by a passage from the Odes of Confucius. We have, for example, a gallant steed, a piebald steed, a white and black steed, and a dappled grey steed. But each verse of the ode begins with these words: galloping, galloping, gallant steed. And you hear that throughout the music. Here it is, King's Messenger.
Thank you. Thank you.
coming to where we offer you the opportunity, our invitation to dance. Not the kind of invitation where you roll back the carpets and take it apart, as we say on the radio, but rather a series of contrasting musical items, but all with a common theme, that of dance. And we have a whole range of such music down the years. We turn first of all to music by Tchaikovsky, a colourful writer, great melodist, and arrangement of extract from the Nutcracker Suite by the band's founder, Dr. Dennis Wright, whose centenary celebrated this year. We're going to hear then just the miniature overture and playback from the Nutcracker.
Thank you.
Dr. Dennis Wright, who I think it's good to say in the 1930s and 40s in particular, who revolutionized the art of arranging and transcription for brass bands, did an awful lot of arrangements. And similarly, later in brass band history, in the 60s and 70s, we find a man called Gordon Langford further revolutionizing the arrangements, particularly of traditional folk tunes. He was a great specialist of this, but he also did some transcriptions. And we're going to hear two of his arrangements now. Two real contrasts, of course, from the pen of Rossini, very exciting, La Danza. And then, I think what I might describe as a tearjerker by Cacciatore. You know it as a theme from the book Needed Mine, volatile to the Adagio, and Spartacus and Phrygia. But first of all, La Danza.
Thank you.
But now we're going to do what I believe is going to be the highlight of tonight's programme. Represents the first commissioning of a brass band work specifically intended for the dancers of Ballet. In bringing together these two seemingly very different worlds, both composer and choreographer have drawn imaginatively and affectionately upon the 19th century tradition of alfresco dancing. The music is structured in a series of variations upon I Dreamt That I Dwelt in Marble Halls, while the choreography presents us with a series of vignettes evocative of the pleasures of a Victorian park on a summer's day. The pooling of the talents of young musicians and dancers produces a spectacle which we hope will give you as much enjoyment as we have derived in bringing this project to fruition. Ladies and gentlemen, Peter Graham's Dancing in the Park.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, and now Oxford is going to meet dancers from the Northern Ballet School, and they're going to perform what has become, for the last few years, possibly one of the most popular and unknown set pieces from all ballet. It's the clog dance, and it's from the ballet La Fille en Ballet. Here we go. The night before, it created quite a lot of problems for the band. This kind of thing is becoming much more normal now. The percussion section is as considered as important as any other section of the band, and it wasn't always so, I have to say. Another indication of this piece was a little form duet, which will be played, I'm quite sure, beautifully this evening. And bands were, in fact, we've always had this rule, one player, one instrument, and they have to change the rules so that one of the cornet players would pick up a flugel to take part in this flugel horn duet. We don't have any such problem in the National Youth Band because we have four flugel horn players anyway. Now, as you'll have seen by your programme, there's probably sometimes into regular notes, so I'll give you a reminder. It's called Dances and Arias. It's got five sections. The first and last that you read, the nice and lively, energetic sections. The middle one of five, is a scherzo. It's also pretty lively, pretty energetic, and with a lot of work for the percussion. And then the two sections in between, the second and the fourth, they're more lyrical, more reflective. First one is slow and tender. The second one features, first of all, a rather big euphonium solo, which is followed by this very beautiful flugelhorn duet leading into the final dance. So, ladies and gentlemen, conclude this evening's concert, National Youth Gospel of Britain, Richard Evans, Edward Gregson's Dances and Arias. Thank you.
Thank you.
dedicated Robert Rickman. Following on the theme about the abandonment of the Ronnie Kirby, there's an awful lot of the concerts. What we tend to forget, we've been doing this for 23 years now. Let's go to see the gentleman, the young man there on the box. He was one of the founder members 43 years ago.
I was three years old.
He's good looking in those days. But one of the things that we can look back on, look at the musical world, the musical scene in Britain today, not only in brass bands, in pretty well all the top orchestras of this country, amongst their ranks there are ex-members of the National Blues Brass Band of Great Britain. So not only players, not only in bands, pretty well all the top bands, all the professional orchestras, a lot of players in the light music scene, in the jazz scene, conductors like Richard, composers and arrangers too, all ex-members of the band. And the final item that we have for you this evening is an arrangement by another ex-member of the band, Ray Farr, who's currently living in Norway. He conducted the Grand Hall Band for several years, was formerly a professional trumpet player with the BBC Radio Orchestra. And he, a few years ago, whilst was with Grand Hall, arranged highlights or excerpts from Stravinsky's Firebird Suite. And we're going to hear part of that arrangement now, the final hymn, and we can turn.